What time does Mass start? They said, Bishop, it starts when you get there. See, in Alaska, travel's never guaranteed. It just isn't. And so what the people of Tenneke knew is that when they would hear the plane come to the village, and many of them, because they lived right there along the water, they would see the plane land right on the water in front of their homes, they knew that when that plane landed, Mass would begin 20 minutes later. And so everybody from the village would gather at the chapel 20 minutes after the plane landed, so that the plane became like the modern day church bell, calling people to the chapel. Absolutely beautiful. And this, you can imagine how glorious the scene was. Well, I have to tell you, if I went into a small diocese like Juneau with a number of questions, you can only imagine the number of questions I'm going to have coming into the Diocese of Dallas. And I must also tell you that it is here that I'm beginning to learn a lot. In preparation for this installation, we have excellent staff in the diocese who have done so much. And in your liturgical aid, you see the photographs of various people. And in preparation for the photograph for me, it was taken here in the cathedral. And I was expressing my gratitude to Annette, the director of communications. I said, Annette, thank you so much for all that you're taking care of. And she said to me, Bishop, as we say here in Texas, this isn't my first rodeo. Well, I have to tell you, I cannot stand here and say, this isn't my first rodeo. I come to you from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, by way of Juneau, Alaska. My friends, I've never been to a rodeo, let alone be in one. So trust me, I'm going to have my questions. And I look forward to working with everyone as I learn so much about this diocese. But what I am convinced of is that I am going to do the best I can as your shepherd. And that I am going to lead this community asking the most important questions. As we evaluate what we do and asking the most important questions, they are, but Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you? When did we see you thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you homeless and give you shelter, naked and clothing? When did we see you sick and in prison and visited you? And Lord, when did we see you a stranger and welcome you? And we will wait for that response, to which our Lord will say, when you did it for the least of my brothers and sisters, you did it for me. We start with this installation, another chapter in the history of this diocese. Today, we received the papal bull, the papal document, and it was Archbishop Pierre, our apostolic nuncio, who said to me, this papal document is for you. You take it to the people. You show the people. And you take the time to make sure that they see it. You know, I have to say that there was a day that I would receive a note from my mother in order to show it to the teacher. Well, today, I had a note from the Pope to show my mother. My friends, that document, the word comes from bullis, the seal, our Holy Father's seal. That document sat on our Holy Father's desk. That document possesses his signature. That document is now here with us in Dallas. And my friends, it is because of that document that I am here in Dallas. And it comes from the successor of St. Peter. St. Peter, to whom Jesus said, "Peter, you are rock. And on this rock, I will build my church. And the jaws of death shall not prevail against it." My friends, we will forever follow Peter. We will forever bind ourselves close to the universal shepherd, for it is through him that we bind ourselves close to Jesus Christ. I pledge that by God's grace, I will do the best in shepherding this local church. And I will ask that we continue to invite people to gather with us in the celebration of word and sacraments. And how we invite them? Whether it's by float plane, church bells, texting, or tweeting, whether it's through the parish bulletin, we will invite them to be with us because Christ calls us to be one body, a community of believers. We find that in today's gospel, Peter, he was asked by Christ to cast the net. And what does Peter say in today's gospel? "Oh, but Lord, we've been hard at it all night long." I have to say that whenever I speak to priests, I always say that that is the example of the first priest who complained. But Peter, what does he do? Sort of like whenever priests receive yet another envelope from the pastoral council, you know, from the pastoral council at parish center, they have to open it up. But what we find is that what does Peter do? He surrenders himself to God's will. He surrenders himself and pulls in a wonderful catch. We're called to exhaust ourselves for Jesus Christ. We're called to truly be his disciples in this world, noticing that he never misses any words with what was going to be asked of us, the hardships as well as the sacrifices. A mis hermanos y hermanas en la comunidad hispana, me tengan firme su fe. Como su obispo, deseo estar con ustedes, orar con ustedes, y aprender de ustedes. A través de la intercesión de Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe, espero ayudar a las familias a mantenerse unidas, dar la bienvenida al forastero, y estar con ustedes a medida que aumentemos nuestra relación con Jesucristo. Manténganse firmes en su jornada de vida y fe. Sepan que nuestra Santa Madre Iglesia está con ustedes. Les pido que me tengan paciencia y confío que me tendrán presente en sus palabras. Espero saludarlos personalmente con el amor del un pastor. And so, my friends, as your shepherd, it is my goal to be with you, to work with you side by side as we advance the mission of the church and the gospel message. I'm humbled to be your shepherd. With you, I hope that we ask all the right questions and how we can better serve our brothers and sisters. Secondly, we will always stay close to our Holy Father, Pope Francis, the successor of St. Peter. And thirdly, we will exhaust ourselves for Jesus Christ. To do all of this, We will strengthen our hearts, our minds, our very lives in the celebration of the word and share and nurture our nourishment with the Eucharist. What we will do is turn to the church for the sacraments which sustains us as disciples. And we will pray with confidence through the intercession of Our Lady of Guadalupe that the Lord will bless our endeavors and give the success to the work of our hands. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. In accordance with the Holy Spirit, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Gracious and loving God, we bring our needs to you this day for ourselves and for the world.
For all who serve the Church and the people of God, Pope Francis, our Bishop Edward, and all the clergy and faithful laity, that they may carry on the Apostles' work with love and mercy, we pray to the Lord. Por nuestro obispo Edward, para que en su ministerio pastoral se encuentre asistido por la fuerza del Espíritu Santo, roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escucha nuestra
oración. For those who are separated from the love of God, in our diocese, our state, and in the world, we pray to the Lord. Por todos los presentes y otros colaboradores, y miembros de los diferentes ministerios en toda la diócesis, encomendados al nuevo obispo, para que el Señor nos dé la gracia y fortaleza de continuar siendo una comunidad viva y misionera bajo su guía, roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escucha nuestra oración.
For the safety of immigrants and migrants, for those who are homeless in our country, and for those who flee inhospitable places, that they may know God's love and our outreach of welcome, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, to consecrated life, to the diaconate, and to lay ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and end to conflict in our homes, our hearts, our families, and our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por todos los que sufren, para que vean en su situación el camino de la salvación y puedan también recobrar el camino de la salud, roguemos al Señor. For those who have died and for those left behind to mourn, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for Bishop Burns and for his family, and for those who have come to support him in his ministry as Chief Shepherd of the Diocese of Dallas, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With hearts filled with gratitude for all you have done for us, O God, and with confident hope in your blessings to come, we ask you to grant these prayers we offer you in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you.
Let us pray with confidence to God.
us now pray that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of us. Holy Father, whose Son chose to wash the disciples' feet, and so set for us an example, accept, we pray, the oblations of our service. Grant that offering ourselves as a spiritual sacrifice, we may be filled with a spirit of humility and zeal. Through Christ our Lord. Just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, creator of the world and source of all life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the paths of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through Christ our Lord. And so, with angels and saints, we too sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, Gregory, our auxiliary bishop, my brother bishops here present, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, and your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise. For they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, your spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Daniel, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were able to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign, marked with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servant, your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, and Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good gifts, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, we may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, before the final blessing, I ask you to please be seated. I'm just so concerned that the words of thanks that I'm going to express are so inadequate to really what is in my heart, the gratitude for all those who have played a significant role in what a wonderful and beautiful celebration this installation mass. First and foremost, to our Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Christophe Pierre, thank you once again for your presence and for being here. Blessings to you and all your journeys back and forth throughout this country of ours. Thank you for your service to us here in the United States. We're so profoundly grateful. To my predecessor, Cardinal Kevin Farrell, once again, thank you for all your support and your pledge of support for the future. I know I mentioned to you, I'm going to take you up on that. So I appreciate your presence. Your Eminence, Cardinal Worrell, thank you for being here and for all that you have done over the years. May God continue to bless you. And Cardinal DiNardo, again, for all that you do in the state of Texas as well as for the United States Conference. Thank you for your presence. I want to say to our Metropolitan Archbishop of San Antonio, Archbishop Gustavo Garcia Silier, thank you so much for all that you do. Again, I look forward to working with you. To all my archbishops and brother bishops who have celebrated here in a special way, to Bishop Grauman, the sixth bishop of the diocese, to the priests of the Diocese of Pittsburgh who have been so, the Diocese of Dallas and the Diocese of Juneau, who have all come here in order to celebrate. I am grateful for your fraternal support. To the seminary rectors, to all the seminarians who are here, thank you for your presence. To the ecumenical and interfaith clergy and representatives who honor me with your presence and with whom I look forward to working with in the many projects ahead. To my family and friends who have traveled so far to be here, I am so blessed and so grateful for your love, affection, and support. To the staff of the Diocese of Dallas, I owe you one, that's for sure. What phenomenal efforts have gone forth from the staff of the Diocese of Dallas. I'm forever grateful. To cathedral staff, thank you for all that you're doing here. And finally, to our diocesan choir, who through your gifts have raised our hearts and voices in prayer and song. Thank you for being here, and thank you for the wonderful music you provided for us. My friends, there's going to be a reception immediately following, and it is located in the Meyerson, and our greeters are outside to help direct you. I look forward to being present with you at our reception. My friends, the Lord be with you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.